Hello student, myself Professor Gada Keses from S&D College of Engineering and Research Center, Eola. Student, we are learning the final year subject, that is the solar and wind energy. So from that subject, we are learning the unit number 5, that is the wind energy. Okay, so related to that unit number 5, we are going to see some topics, that is the types of windmill in the today's lecture. Up to the last lecture, we have seen what is the wind energy, why we are using the wind energy, what is the history of that wind energy, that also we have seen. Now, in the today's lecture, we are going to start the next point, that is the types of wind machine, that means types of wind mills. So that all of you know, for generation of electricity with the help of wind mills are required. So wind mills contain different parts again. So different components also we are going to understand, but first we will understand how many types of wind machines, that is wind mills, are available in the current scenario. So let's see, there are two types of wind machines, that are turbines used today based on the direction of the rotation shaft, that is the horizontal axis wind machine and vertical axis wind machine. As per the name, horizontal axis and vertical axis wind mills, we know or we understand how that wind mill will be there. I am going to show you one figures and details regarding to that horizontal and vertical axis wind mill. The size of the wind machines varies widely. That means that size of the wind machines depends on the availability of the air flow. So if large air flow is available, we can use the large wind mill. But if air flow is not adequate, so we will use the smaller wind mill. The small wind turbines use the power a single home or business maybe have capacity of less than 1000 kilowatts. Some large commercial size turbine may have the capacity of 5 million watts or 5 megawatts also. Larger turbines are often grouped together in wind farms that provides power to the electrical grid also. That means we can use the wind machine for the single home purpose also, we can use for the industry also, and we can use the wind machines for supplying the power to the power grid also. That means as per our requirement, we can use the wind machines. Okay, so let's see the two types of the actual types of the power wind machine. First one, horizontal axis. So let's see, here a diagram is given, horizontal axis. So if you are able to see that horizontal machine, wind machine, so here the shaft of the axis of the shaft is in the horizontal position, that's why it is called as a horizontal shaft machine. So here some parts are given, cable carries the electricity to transmit the lines, then blades catch the wind and spin, then generators convert mechanical energy into electrical energy, computer system controls direction of the wind. So that's are some points, or that's are some components, that's why we are going to see in the detail again. So let's see what they have said about horizontal axis wind machine. Most wind machine being used today are the horizontal axis type. Why horizontal axis type? Because the air flows normally in the horizontal direction. That's why we are using normally the horizontal axis type of the wind machine. So horizontal axis wind machine have the blades like the airplane profile. A typical horizontal wind machine stands as tall as a 20 story buildings. How much longer it will be? 20 story buildings, up to the size of 20 story building, and has three blades that span 200 feet across. The largest wind machine in the world has the blade longer than the football field. The wind machine stands tall and wide to capture the more winds. All of you understand, that is about the horizontal axis wind machine. Then vertical axis wind machine. So for the horizontal axis, the shaft axis of the shaft is in the horizontal position, but for the vertical axis shaft wind machine, the axis of the shaft is in the vertical position. So let's see, the vertical axis wind machine have the blades that goes from top to bottom and most common types looks like gained two-bladed edge VHS. The types of the vertical wind machines typically stand 100 feet tall and 50 feet wide. 100 feet tall and 50 feet. But for horizontal axis wind machine, it is a 20-story building size. All of you understand that? The vertical axis wind machine make up only a very small percent of wind machines used today. That means vertical axis wind machines are used smaller as compared to the horizontal axis wind machines. The wind amplifier rotor platform is a different kind of wind system that is designed to more efficient and use less land than the wind machine in the use today. The VARP does not use large blades, instead it looks like a stack of wheels rims. Each module has a pair of small high capacity turbine mounted to both of its concave wind amplifier modules channel surface. The concave surface channel winds toward the turbine amplifying wind speeds by the 50% or more. The company that designed VARP plans to market the technology to power offshore oil platforms and wireless telecommunication system. All of you understand? So that's are the two types of the horizontal axis wind machine and vertical axis wind machine. We will see that in the details and along with its components. So horizontal axis wind machine we have to focus mainly. We are going to discuss that once again and along with its components also. So next topic we will continue in the next lecture. So in the today's lecture we have discussed two types of wind machines or two types of wind mills. So horizontal axis wind mill and vertical axis wind mill. So we are generally using the horizontal axis wind machines. So next point, that is components of horizontal axis wind machine, that we will see in the next lecture.